us direction from above. We need a word from the Lord, a word from the
Lord.
Just one word.
So we look into the word this morning. We do. And are desiring and are pursuing that we might be able to live out the word of God.
And give us peace.
As we are in the last Sunday of Loyalty Month, we have been sharing messages to inspire us to be loyal to God.
All right.
There's no other loyalty that you should have, no other person that you should be closer to than the Lord. And if we could be loyal to the Lord, there are many problems that we are facing that we probably wouldn't face. Hello?
Hello?
If we could be loyal to the Lord, we could really be blessed even more beyond measure. So we want to encourage you to be loyal to the Lord, to love God with all of your heart, with all of your mind, with all of your might, with all of your strength. Love Him with all that you are. And speaking of loving God with all of our hearts, what is the greatest indication, an indicator of your love for anyone? What's the greatest indicator? How can you or how do you show your love? What is the one greatest indicator?
Action.
Actions. That's a good word. Love and loyalty is an action word. But Jesus said in the scriptures that where something is, your heart will be also.
Yeah. All right.
Where your what is, where your treasure is, there will your heart be also.
Amen.
So God says to love Him with all of our hearts, mind, and soul, with all of our hearts. He says then, where your treasure is, there your heart will be. If you treasure God, then you can answer the importance of what's on the front of your bulletins. Why is it important to be loyal and giving? If you love God,
all right,
you will be loyal in your giving. And if you're loyal in your giving, there's something that you will reap. And this is the closest to prosperity preaching that I get. This is the closest to prosperity preaching that the Bible teaches. If you want to be blessed by God, you have to give. Say to your neighbor, neighbor.
Neighbor.
Oh, neighbor.
Oh, neighbor.
If you want to be blessed,
by God,
you have to give. Amen, and praise the Lord. We're going to be sharing a message entitled Loyalty and Giving this morning, and let's go ahead and stand to our feet as we answer the question to the importance of loyalty and giving this morning through Proverbs 3, 9, and 10. Please stand in reverence for the Word of God. Stand symbolically saying that I will stand on the Word of God. Say to your neighbor, neighbor.
Neighbor.
Oh, neighbor.
Oh, neighbor.
I'm going to stand
on the Word of God.
And I'm going to live it out. Let's read this on three. One, two, three.
Honor the Lord with your wealth,
with the first fruits of all your crops. Then your barns will be filled to overflowing.
Amen. Stay there, stay there. You may be sitting in the household of the Lord. Okay.
With your mom.
Says, honor the Lord with your wealth. With your wealth. That's an inside joke. That's an inside joke. Maybe you get it. With the first fruit of your crops. Then your barns will be filled to overflowing. And your vats will what?
Brim over.
Brim over, overflow with
new wine.
Amen. And praise the Lord. We're going to share 3 points this morning. We're going to talk about to give honor. We're going to talk about to give headmost. We're going to talk about to get hyped. And this morning we want the Christians to know that they should be lawgivers.
Amen.
You should be a lawgiver. Let me kind of define loyalty, okay, and giving. Okay? And we'll define it by our work, okay? Would your employer think that you are a loyal employee if you only showed up once a week?
No.
Okay, how about, okay, I do, and I grow more, and I only show up twice a week. Okay, well, maybe I grow a little more, and I show up 3 times a week. I mean, 3 times out of 5, now that's a good number, isn't it?
No.
okay, I'm going to make employee of the month, and I'm going to show up 4 days out of every week. Wait a minute, 4 out of 5? Ain't that a good number, 4 out of 5? Every week I'm going to be there 4 times out of 5. Isn't that long? Okay. If I'm only required to work 5 days and I show up 5 days, then I'm what?
Lord.
Then I'm Lord. Okay. Let's put it in the area of giving. If I give only 1 time a month, now I may get paid once a month, so that could be good, okay? But if I get paid every week, and I show up to church, and I give to the Lord only out of 4 weeks, I only give to God only 1 time. Is that law?
No.
Oh, okay. I go. He says, "Going, how much you give?" okay. If you continue to get blessed, you know, then that brings a good question. Do I give God just what I regularly make, or if I get blessed on the side, like some of us about to get our tax returns, do I give to God on the tax return?
Yes.
You're supposed to. Okay. Do I give on the gross, or do I give on the net?
Gross.
You give on the gross. I like to say what you want to be blessed on. But anyway, these are questions to think about when you think about being Lord of God. Okay. Do I give? What if I just give? I give in the winter. Okay. I give in the spring.
Uh-oh.
I give in the fall.
Uh-oh.
But summertime comes. Am I loyal? Am I giving? Hello? Okay. We want to share this morning, answer the question to why is law to be good to be loyal and giving? And law means to be faithful. Amen? And this morning, we're going to look at what God wants us to do with our wealth. Number one, God wants us to honor Him with our wealth. Amen? To give honor, it says, honor the Lord with your wealth.
Yeah.
Honor the Lord.
But what we need is a special word that will burn within our heart and give us direction.